Welcome back for another class. I hope you have seen all the other videos in civics and you all are also revising and writing the answers in your notebook and even marking them, some of them in your book. So let us start with another unit, that is unit 6, understanding media. Now this is a part of the fourth unit, that is unit. In this we will be studying about media, and in the next chapter, that is the seventh chapter, we will be studying about advertising. So first let's take up understanding media. Now in this chapter we will be seeing many other points. So let's see first these three points, that is media and technology, media and money, media and democracy. How media is related to technology, money and democracy. Now in today's media and advertising, there are persuasive preferences in the young lives of young people. Yeah, we are so attracted towards media. We are seeing news channels, we are seeing business news, we are seeing fashion news, and we see not only this but the media we hear also, right? In the radio, then we see in the TV. So all these are the form of media. Now the focus of understanding media is on explaining and strong links between media and technology and media and big businesses. It explains how the media sets its agenda to influencing our perceptions of issues worth devoting time and attention to, and issues that are neglected or overridden. Yes, we see a lot of things in the media. We see a lot of news that comes up in the media, how, where people don't know, all around the world, right? We don't know what is happening all around the world. So media helps us to get in touch with the world, the whole world. So let's start with the chapter. Now, what is your favorite TV program? What do you like listening to? The radio, newspaper, magazines? Do you surf the internet? And what do you found most useful about? Did you know that there is one word that is often used in the collective reference to radio, TV, newspaper, internet and several other ways of communication? This all together is known as media. So in this chapter we will be reading more about media and how it is connected to technology, democracy and money. Now everything ranging from stalls at the local fair to the program that you see on the TV can be called as media. Now media is a plural form of medium. Yeah, media has come from the word medium. So it describes the various ways in which we get communication or we get communicate from in the society. Right? It's a medium. Now we cannot directly communicate in the society, or we directly don't know anything in the society, so it's a medium for us to communicate in the society or communicate with the society. Because media refers to all the means of communication. Now we have different means of communication. We have radio, we have television, we have internet, newspaper, magazines, diaries, journals. We have so many different ways of communicating. Now everything ranging from a phone call to the evening news on TV can be called as media. So from the media we are able to connect to millions of people all around the globe. Now the first thing, media and technology. Now it would probably be difficult for you to imagine your life without media. Can you imagine your life without internet? Without radio, without TV, or without newspaper? No. But cable television and the widespread use of internet is a recent phenomenon. These have been around for less than 20 years. The technology that mass media uses keep changing. Yeah. In early times, they were radio. The way of communicating was either newspaper or radios. Then came black and white television. Then after that came color TVs. Then came internet, and then there are so many. Now in the early time there was only Doordarshan. Now there are so many channels in the radio that you hear. Now new internet, you can surf in the internet, hundred millions of things you want to. So every time, everything is, the mass media is keeps magazines as a print media and TV and radio as electronic media. Now, media is divided into two parts, that is print media and electronic media. Now, print media is that is written, that is newspaper, magazines, journals, books, billboards, all these are print media, pamphlets. Now, what electronic media is? Internet, radio and television. Now, as you read further, you will find that the naming is related to different technologies that we use media use. The following photographs, we will give you a sense of the way in which technology that mass media uses has changed over the years and continues to change. Changing technologies or machines and making technology more modern helps media to reach more people. Yes, because it is changing, so previously there was only Doordarshan, then there came TV, black and white TV, so then color TV, then more channels and then internet. So it is a machine that is making it is a machine that is changing. Technological changes are going on and it is making things easier for us to reach. It also improves the quality of sound and images that you see. But technology does more than this. It also changes the way in which we think about our lives. For example, today it is quite difficult for us to think of lives without television. Television has enabled us to think ourselves as members of large global world. Television images travel huge distances through satellites and cables. Yeah. You have Dish TV, you have local cable channels, and how they reach you? Through a wire, the local and local TV, local cable and dish, from the dish antenna, from the satellite, the other networks reaches you. So satellites and cable help you to these pictures and these technology travel to your place. This allows us to view news and entertainment channels from other parts of the world. So we are not only connected with India or where we live, like Jabalpur. We are connected with around the world what is happening. The news channel, if you open the news channel will show whatever is happening in India and around the world. So we are connected with that. Now, and then we have different channels in the TV. We have fashion channels, we have lifestyles, we have cookery shows, we have music, English or Hindi music channels, and they are not only one channel, there are several channels of certain categories. We have movie channels, English and Hindi, then we have different channels. You have several different channels that entertain you. Now, most of the cartoons that you see on television are mostly from Japan or the United States. We can now be sitting in Chennai or Jammu Kashmir and see images of a storm that hit the coast of Florida in United States. So television has brought the world closer. It has made the world very small. So by sitting here in Jabalpur, we can see things that is happening in America or in the North Pole. We can see whatever is happening there because of the media and technology. Because the technology has become so advanced. Now the next is media and money. Now the different technologies of mass media use are very expensive. Just think about the TV studio in which the news reader sits. Yeah, you have seen different news channel. You must have seen how glamorous they look with a nice suit and they sit there, and the newsroom and all the settings are so, and they use very advanced gadgets to communicate with us and to the other people that they are bringing the news from. So that is requires a lot of expense, a lot of money, like the lights, the camera, the sound recorders, transmission satellites, all of which costs a lot of money. So a news studio, it is not only a news reader who reads to be paid, but also a number of other people. Yes, the cameraman, the spot boy, or the you can say the broadcaster. So there are so many, the lightsman, the news reader that is bringing the news from the other place. So there are so many to be paid. on getting the latest technologies. Due to these costs, the mass media needs a great deal of money. Yeah, so because such a lot of money is required to bring up everything together and to reach to us. So as a result, most of the television channels and newspapers are big business houses. Yeah, that means that they are owned by big business houses because a lot of investment is required. So there are a lot of investors and big business houses are involved in these news channels. Now, mass media is constantly thinking of ways to make money. Now, what do you think how they can make money? Now, they can make money through the advertisements that come in between. Like when a news channel is there, a news is running or something. So, you can see there are so many ads that comes in between. So, they earn from there also. Now, one way in which the mass media earns is by advertising different things like cars, chocolates, medicines, different things, electrical appliances, clothes, there are so many things. Now, you must have noticed that a number of advertisements that you see have while watching your favorite television show, while watching a cricket match also, right? When you watch a cricket match on a TV channel, they are sponsored, you know, in every cricket match, or you will see a big logo of Pepsi, or you can see of Reliance, of Oppo. So they wear the t-shirt, they have the logos also. That means that company has sponsored that show. So that is how, there's another way that they earn. As you will read in this following chapter, advertisements are also repeated in the hope that you will go out and buy what is advertised. Yes, that we will learn in the next chapter, and how does advertise influence people and then you want to buy something. So that we will read in the next chapter. So that is how these big media houses, they get a lot of investments. How they invest? Because of doing these advertisements and sponsors. The sponsors that they get, they are able to get money, and they are owned by itself big business houses that give them a lot of money. Now the next is media and democracy. Now when we talk about media and democracy, democracy means that everybody has the right to speak. We have the right to put our thoughts in front. It's like for democracy, we are living in a democratic country, so we have the right to speak, right to have meetings, or right, like we as we say that democracy is giving us the right of as a citizen. So in a democracy, the media plays a very important role in providing news and discussing events taking place in our country and in the world. It's on the basis of the information that citizen can, for example, learn how the government works. Yeah, because there are so many things that the media show us. The news channels that they show that the government is doing for the people, like their different sponsors or giving donations or giving money to the poor people, paying away of the loan. So there are so many things. So the media helps us to know about all these things. And often it is a wish too that they take action on the basis of these news stories. Some of the way in which they can do this is by writing letters to the concerned ministers, organizing a public protest, starting a signature campaign, asking the government to rethink its program. So there are so many ways that the media puts in front so that we can see and decide as being a citizen. Given the role that the media plays in providing information, it is important that the information be balanced. Yes, when we talk about media and democracy, that means the news that we see shouldn't be partial news, or they shouldn't be partial to one community or one party. They shouldn't be partial, or they have to have a balanced news. That means they cannot be showing one type or supporting one and then disrespecting the other. So then that will not be a media and democracy. So they have to have a balance in between what they show to the people. So that is very important. Now let's understand, what do you mean by a balanced report? By reading two versions of the same news events on the next page. Now see, I'll read out to you a news that is two types of news, and you have to find out were they balanced or balanced news or not. So first one says, crackdown on polluting factories, protesters block roads and disrupt traffic. Violent protests by owners and workers brought the city to a standstill today. People getting to work could not do so on time because of huge traffic jams. The owner and the workers are protesting the government's decision to close down polluting factory units. Although the government did take this decision rather hastily, the protesters have known for quite some time and the units are not legal. Moreover, the level of pollution in the city will be greatly reduced by this closure. Mr. Jain, a well-known figure in the city, said, with our city gradually becoming India's new business hub, it is important that it would be a clean and green city. Polluting factories should be moved. The factory owners and workers should accept the relocation being offered by the government instead of protesting. So this was the first part of the news. Now see the next part. Closure of factory causes unrest. So this is the same news but in a different form. The closure of one lakh factories in the city residential areas are likely to become a serious issue. On Monday, thousands of factories, owners and workers took a street to strongly protest the closure. They said that their livelihoods would be lost. They say that the fault lies in the municipal corporation because it continued to issue license for new factories to set up in residential areas. They also said that there were no adequate relocation efforts. The owners and workers plan one day city bund to protest against the closure. Mr. Sharma, one of the factory owners, said, the government says that it has done a lot of relocate us, but the area that they have sent us has no facilities and have not been developed for the last 5 years. Now, can you tell me, girls, what is the difference? They are the same news, but can you tell me the difference between the two news? In fact, that if you read either news, you would know one side of the story. Yes, if you read the one news, you will know the one side of the story. And if you read the next news, you will know the other side of the story. Because in the first news, they have never told anything about the municipal cooperation. So, if you had read the news of India, you would most likely to think that the protesters as a nuisance. Right? If what I read in the first news, if you see that, they all are talking about the protesters being a nuisance they are creating. And in the second one, that is, and they're disrupting the traffic, they are continually polluting the city, and they are leaving a bad impression. Now, in the second, that is about from the Daily News Service, it tells you about, because it tells you about the situation that they are facing, and that is why they are protesting. Because they are being relocated and they don't have any further facilities. So they are, you can see there are difference between the two news. So they are not balanced news. They are taking sides of one or the other. So neither of these two story is a balanced report. So a balanced report should be a good and a bad side of a news should be shown or written. So then only it will become a balanced news. So a balanced report is one that discusses all points of views of the particular story and then leave it to the reader to make up their mind. So yeah, so it is depending upon the reader to make up the mind that the story is right or wrong and what side the reader wants to take. So writing a balanced report, however, depends on the media independence. So an independent media that knows no one should control and influence coverage of news. And one should tell the media that can be included and then what should not be included.